Good morning, students. As we already had discussed about the hormones in the regular classes, so now today we will discuss about the MC, that is menstrual cycle, right? As all of you know that the sexual cycle in female, when a girl reaches at a puberty, okay, the sixth hormone estrogen causes either of the ovaries to release an ovum. So what happens when the release of ovum, that means the eggs or the ova are released, at that time what happens? Now you can see, at the time of the maturation of ovum, there is a release of an ovum from an ovary into the fallopian tube. We already had discussed in the reproduction chapter, right? Then when the ovums are released in the fallopian tube, either of the one of the ovary, right? Then thickening of the inner wall of the uterus. At that time, when we release the eggs or the ova in the fallopian tube, and after that thickening of the inner wall of the uterus. At that time, when they will come into the uterus, if the egg is fertilized in the fallopian tube, if the sperms will come, and if the egg is fertilized, then the menstruation cycle stops. Right? At that time, if the egg is fertilized, at that time menstrual cycle stop. Fertilized egg develop into a embryo and then into fetus. If the egg is fertilized, MC stop. Then what happens? Egg is developed into, I'm writing here, developed into an embryo and then fetus. Is this clear? If the egg is fertilized at that time, MC, that is menstrual cycle, stop, and egg is developed into an embryo and then grow as a fetus. And in the second case, if the egg is not fertilized, what happened in that case? If the egg is not fertilized, then the breaking of the thick and soft lining of the uterus takes place. I am erasing this. At that time, if egg is not fertilized, in that case, if the egg is not fertilized, in that case, breaking of thick and soft inner lining of the uterus That means if the eggs are not fertilized, they attached to the they stick to the inner lining of the uterus, and at that time breaking of the thick and the soft inner lining of the uterus takes place. At that time, thick and soft inner lining of the uterus, thick and soft inner lining of the uterus, along with blood and dead ovum comes out right, it comes out through vagina in the form of bleeding called menstruation. Through vagina in the form of bleeding is called menstruation. Is this clear? If the egg is fertilized, then they develop, menstruation cycle stop, and they develop into an embryo and then fetus. And if the egg is not fertilized, then the breaking of the and soft inner lining of the uterus, and this lining comes out along with the blood and the dead ovum through vagina in the form of bleeding, and that is called menstruation. This is what about the menstrual cycle. Now, the next topic, two terms we have to note it down. One is called menarche and menopause. Right? Menarche and menopause. The first menstrual flow, menarche means the first menstrual flow, which begins at puberty, in women, that is called the menarche. So what is the meaning of the menopause? That is stoppage of the pause. The stoppage of menstrual flow at the age of 45 to 50 years. At the age of the 45 to 50 years, when it stops in female, at that time these are called, this is called menopause, and this is menarche, the first menstrual flow, which begins at the puberty, that is starting from the age like 11 to 12 or the 13 years of the puberty, right? These two terms you have to note it down, right? After that, we will discuss the very important topic, determination of the sex of a baby, means how we will determine ki boy or a girl. Write down. Of a baby. How we will come to know that the baby is boy or a girl? How we will check? How we can determine that one? Right? Inside the fertilized egg, we can say inside the fertilized egg or a zygote, right, is the instruction for the determination of the sex of a baby. What I am saying, inside the fertilized egg or the zygote is the instruction for the determination of the sex of the baby. Instructions is present, right, instruction is present in the thread-like structures called chromosomes. Instruction is present in the thread-like structures called chromosomes. So chromosomes are present in the nucleus of the every cell. That you already know, chromosomes are present inside the nucleus of the every cell. All human beings have 23 pair of pairs of chromosome in the chromosomes in the nucleus of the cell. Is it clear? 23 chromosomes. Out of these 23 pair of chromosomes, two chromosomes out of all these are the sex chromosomes. Two chromosomes
out of these are sex chromosomes. Is it clear, beta? Right? And that is a X and Y. Right? Now, note it down here. In female and in case of the male, XX chromosome is present. The sex chromosomes are same, like XX. And in case of the male, one is X and one is Y. X is for the girl and Y is for the boy. When they fuse together like this one, and we can also do like in this way. Right? This X will combine with this. This X will combine with this. Right? Then this is girl and boy. Female has two X chromosomes and the male has one X and one is the Y. Y is for the boy. When these two X, that is the fusion of the X chromosome or the sex chromosome, if it X fuse with the X, then the girl will be. And if the X fuse with the Y, then the baby will be boy. By this, we can check the determination of the sex of a baby. So these are the myths that the girls are responsible for the girl child. That is wrong. Because girls has the same chromosome. In male, they are having the two different chromosome, X as well as a Y. And Y is responsible for the baby boy. Is that clear? After that, we will discuss the next thing, next topic in the next lecture. Thank you.